neighborhood. The lower. Around here, the record store was there on Avenue A. Adam Ad-Rock Horovitz, Mike D. Diamond, and Adam MCA Yauch just wanted to be part of the scene. You all went to different schools.
But we would hang out at the same place.
Yeah.
So that's the thing. We're drawn to the same thing.
Yauch and Diamond rented their first apartment here on Christie Street. You had a sweatshop above you and a bordello below you.
Yeah, the bordello was on this floor and below.
A legend.
This is a legend. We're not legend.
But they were allowed to rehearse their music.
As soon as we heard that, it was like, okay, great. Where do we sign?
The group, formed as a punk band, was soon drawn to a new sound.
What did you hear in rap?
That was the first time I heard something that sounded totally radical. You know, that where I was like, wait a second, that's, I don't know what it is, but I want that.
They signed to a new label, Def Jam Records, who got them a gig opening for an up-and-coming singer named Madonna.
We're going to play in front of gazillions of teenage girls, and they all hated us.
They
really hated us. And their parents hated us more.
And had a bad
hated deal. Us.
It was really bad. It was terrible.
I mean, passionately.
But in 1986, they made their first album. Mike D played it for Run of Run DMC.
And when he gets to the end, he's like, you know, you're going to have a gold album.
Were you ready for what happened?
No.
Licensed to Ill became the first rap album to hit number one. The headline in the Village Voice, Three Jerks Make a Masterpiece.
You gotta fight for your right.
You just go along for the ride.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, kind of, yeah, when you're 19, it's a great ride.
But it got bumpy the next year when a riot broke out at their Liverpool concert. The Beastie's brash behavior became a tabloid target.
By the time we got to this incident in England, we kind of realized, wow, we've become that thing that we were making fun of, and this is not cool. It doesn't feel good. Maybe we should just be ourselves and not do that.
But to their own surprise, the Beastie Boys became rap's most enduring group, producing 7 platinum albums.
Yeah,
up until 2009, when they played the Bonnaroo Music Festival.
You obviously didn't know it was going to be your last concert.
It's better that way.
Soon after the gig, Adam Yauch revealed on YouTube.
I actually have a form of cancer in the gland that's over here.
In 2012, less than a month after the band was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Yauch died at 47. The news caused a global outpouring of grief.
How did you feel about that, seeing that, the size of that?
If you had a friend pass away and that happened all around the world, people writing graffiti and doing posters, it's bizarre. But it felt really good to know that so many people cared about my friend, you know?
Walk with Ad-Rock and Mike D through their old neighborhood.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you right back.
And you'll see how loyal their fans are still.
Like, we're a weird band. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think that we're supposed to be a band that lasted this long.
You have a greater appreciation for what you've done after you put this all together?
I think we do look back at the sort of the trajectory of it all and the impossibility of it all and the unlikeliness of it all, and we appreciate that.